one thing that got me tripping. It's this one thing that got me tripping today. This one thing.
Let's share some secrets. So, my very first one is that I have never been trained in dance ed. Like, I never took it. Yeah, I know. Surprising, right? And let me tell you why. So by the time I was around 4, my mom suggested that I would take a ballet class at a dance studio. And I looked into it and I started breaking down in tears and then I cried and said no. When I was around 4, I never did dance ed. This is also by the time I started Korean dance. So as I've been doing traditional Korean dance with Chumsaran Korean Dance Group, never did dance ed at all. I never did ballet, I never did tap, I never did jazz. That's what probably shocked you over there. And you're probably like, oh Viv, don't you do dance in PE right now? During your junior year? Well, yes. It's just to help me catch up on, like, styles that I never did before in my life. Like, I've never been trained in jazz. Well, technically, since I'm in Ladies First, it's just, like, simple jazz moves while singing, which is what I'm used to. But I've never been trained in, like, intense jazz. And I never trained in ballet. The main reason why I didn't do dance ed is because I was too scared. With the help of Dance One in my PE class, it could help me overcome any childhood fears. So because of that, I felt a lot more comfortable in the dance world. So yeah, that's true.
I forgot to mention that I'm into hip-hop, usually. So, hip-hop dancers, if you want to hit me up, then hit me up, man.
That was my first ever secret. And for my second secret, I have had a few crushes on some guys. Ooh. but, before you say anything, they did not love me back.
Aww.
Yeah, I know. Really sad, huh? Let me tell you why. So, around middle school, there was this guy that I really, really liked. I used to think, oh my god, he is so cute, and figured we'd be the perfect match, boyfriend-girlfriend. There was this one moment when he sat next to me in science class, which is kind of romantic, but never, like, talked to him in class. Like, I would just, like, greet him happily, and by the time I wanted to, like, talk to him, he wasn't quite really interested in me, so that was kind of a heartbreak. Like, I really liked him, but he didn't really like me back. So, that's pretty disappointing. Yeah, I know. Very disappointing for a first crush, right? A similar thing had happened when I was with Tom. We have been inseparable best friends, like, since elementary school. And I figured I would be the perfect match with him. Like, I had a crush on Tom. Like, be, like, constantly, like, looking at him by photo, and we'd be, like, texting each other and like, going out to, like, eat at certain places, like a date. By the time we entered around, like, 8th grade or so, he had a crush on a different girl and left me behind. I know. Another disappointing fact. I love this guy so much, but it turns out we're not boyfriend-girlfriend. It's just a good relationship. Like, just friends with no benefits. I know. Okay, haha, laugh at that. Haha. So that is true. I did have a few crushes, but like two of the guys did not accept my love. All right, moving on to the third secret. Now for the third one. When I was pretty young, I used to be obsessive with thinking about getting braces. And right now I regret it. Yeah, I know. And again, this is super shocking. I've always wanted to have braces since I was young because I thought they were gonna be cool, and by the time I actually got them, which was after, like, few days after my 14th birthday, I got them for the first time, and it turns out I regretted my decision. And I still have these. It's been, like, what, almost 3 years? And still not okay with them. Like, I at first thought the braces thing was gonna be good, but then it was kind of a dumb idea. That was really stupid of me. I don't really like my braces that much, but I mean, I still do, don't get me wrong. It's just sometimes I get very self-conscious about, like, how other people would think, Especially if I'm, like, the influencer wannabe type. Just like a few of my other friends. It's true that I've got a few that are wanting to be, like, social media influencers, so... Yeah, that's true. And as part of my braces situation, I had to wear a headgear, which is also worse. It's really bad, because I couldn't, like, sleep pretty comfortably with it on. I have a pillow on my bed that helps with sleeping at a better position while wearing my headgear. And my orthodontist, they recommended that I would wear the headgear 11 hours, like, at least 11 hours a day or more, or else I would have to get surgery, which I absolutely don't want.
Get away from me!
I don't want to be crying like a dog anymore. Surgery is what I'm, like, worried about right now. Like, I'm scared.
I'm about to freak out!
Like, surgery has not happened to me before in my life, and in case that happens, I would probably cry in my bed. So, my third secret was that I thought getting braces would be cool, but I regretted my decision on that. So, yeah, what can I say? Now for the fourth secret, I feel that probably most of you are probably going to disagree when I say this, but you're probably going to agree with this one with me right now. I have been teased and bullied before. That's very scary, right? It's true, I have been bullied ever since, like, it was ever since, when I had grade school at that time, from, like kindergarten all the way to 8th grade. The bullying occurred mostly in middle school. No, not middle school, elementary school. Like, I was very different from all the Korean students, and I felt really scared a lot. Like, other kids just, like, wanted to, learn a lot of the Korean cultures and aspects, and I wanted to just, like, get out, just to be safe. They pretty much hated the fact that I was different from them, and it was not very clever at all. The reason why is because they did not know the fact that I had food allergies while the other kids did not. They even made fun of me, which was worse. It was also during the time I met Stephanie, but we're good friends now, we're good friends. Between Stephanie and I, well, she used to be mean to me, but she's a friend. She became a friend of mine since 7th grade. In elementary school of Korean school, I did not have any friends at all. I felt very lonely, I couldn't socialize because I couldn't figure out how to talk in Korean, and it was very scary, and I don't want to cry. I've also been bullied in dance when I was very young as well. I've posted something like that on my Instagram page. If you haven't followed me on Instagram, just go ahead and do so. Follow me at hey_itsvivianj. What I posted was this repost of We Are Mint Crew's video of us dancing to Girls' Generation, I Got a Boy. So, the caption I said that I loved dancing with diverse K-pop groups, and explained why. This has to do with how I was bullied in dance. It's just that I've been stereotyped about my body image. Like, I've been called fat a few times before, and it was not very good at all. When that occurred, I felt very insecure, and felt bad about myself, and didn't like who I was. However, I didn't give up or quit dance, because dance and performing arts has been a part of my life, and it has encouraged me to accept myself. I'm also reading the caption. By participating more K-pop dance workshops and dance classes, it made me the person I was meant to be. So thank you so much at We Are Mint Crew, and this is a message to all you guys. Because of all you guys that have been my fans of my YouTube page for years, I've felt more happier and happier. And in the comments, Diamond said, "Yep, I'm crying. Thank you, honey bun. You're so sweet and I was so happy seeing you at the workshop. You really did a great job at learning the dances no matter how challenging they may have been. I really appreciate and admire how you pushed through and even gave it your own style. You're beautiful and I hope you always keep pushing and work towards your goals, baby." Jeanette said, "Thanks, girl. Keep pushing. Negative comments always come and go, but don't let that stop your dreams." I'm very grateful to have those people in my mind because they've encouraged me to keep doing what I love and don't let other people stop me from whatever I'm very passionate about. This is why I've been very grateful to have Jeanette and Diamond from Mint. If you both are watching this right now, I love you all so much. Can't live without them. So it's true. For my fourth secret, I have been bullied in life and in dance. So in terms of change, I managed to get a new look, and I let go and forget all this, like, bullying moments thing, and I was never made fun of again. And now for my fifth secret, fifth and final one. I am pretty much a scaredy cat. Yeah. I know, that surprised you, right? You're probably thinking, oh my god, Viv, you're not afraid, are you? Like, you're not afraid of performing. Well, it's not performing that I'm afraid of, it's just certain things that just freak me out. Like, I've got some pretty big fears like a bunch of my other friends do. I used to be afraid of thunder and lightning, but got over that eventually. But, I'm afraid of being a few feet off the ground. Like, for example, when I was in the gymnastics unit of my freshman PE class, we were attempting to do the uneven bars, and I couldn't really, like, stay on the bar for too long. I was so scared that I felt like I was gonna die, and I cried. So one of my fears is, like, just, like, being physically up, like, off the ground. Technically, I'm not afraid of, like, when I'm on the plane or anything. It's just when I'm physically, like, off the ground, I get so scared. This is really strange because I like roller coasters a lot. I just don't like the uneven bars in gymnastics because, like, you're just, like, literally trying to, like, hold your strength up and, like, I was, like, in this position, then all of a sudden I go, bleh! Oh, man. It's just because of my noodle arms. And another fear that I do have is just driving at night, which is really dumb. It's just for, like, survival purposes. Whenever I'm, like, driving, like, with my dad at night, it sometimes goes into, like, horror movie mode. Like, I'd be, like, trying hard not to, like, panic or feel sick in my stomach. Like, even the same thing with spiders. I hate spiders and insects a lot. Like, real-life insects, even the plastic ones, they scare me every time. What I'm also afraid of is blood. Yeah. Which is also stupid. Like, I don't know why I'm afraid of blood. Like, if someone is, like, bleeding, I would be totally calm and okay, but if it's, like, only my blood, for instance, like, if there's, like, blood coming out of, like, my mouth and such, I would be like, what the heck is going on? I know. That is another weird fear, right? Usually people would be, like, totally calm and okay with it, but for me, oh no, absolutely not. Like, there was this moment, like, I was brushing my teeth, right? And then all of a sudden I see this, like, red stuff on my toothbrush and I go, ah! Like, I freaked out. I was worried. I'm like, what is wrong with my teeth? Like, why is it bleeding? Gum inflammation or something? Like, oh man, that freaked me out so much. I mean, I'm not afraid of blood, like, when I got my ears pierced for the first time, I was not scared at all. If it's just, like, my own personal blood, I would, like, probably freak out, but not, like, in a panic mode. So yeah, my fifth secret was that I have some very strange fears. Even this one is, like, the most weirdest one. Not everyone probably has this, but I sometimes feel like I've been, like, haunted. I usually don't like to talk about this. Like, this is just part of the secrets that I've been sharing with y'all for today. So I sometimes feel like that I do believe that my house is haunted, sometimes. Like, for example, I would be closing my bedroom doors, like, before I go to bed at night, and then in the morning, sometimes when I wake up, I see my bedroom doors open. That is so weird. And sometimes, like, I can hear, like, presence and spirits in a very dark room, or, like, hear some, like, noises that other people can't really hear. So I'm kind of like a dog. Like, sometimes at night, when it gets a little loud, I can hear, like, some, like, weird sounds, like, coming from, like, outside my bedroom or, like, in this room. Right now, I'm totally okay. There's, like, nothing that's going to, like, creep me out or anything. But sometimes, like, in my head, I may go crazy when I say this, but whenever I'm in a dark room, I could sometimes hear, like, footsteps or, like, something is, like, opening. I'm pretty psychic. Pretty freaky, right? So those are all my secrets that I've shared with y'all. I hope a lot of you are probably, like, mind blown when I talked about those in front of y'all. If you do believe me right now, just smash the thumbs up for the sake that I just told you some truths. Like, things that you don't already know, but now you already know. And also, hopefully this did not, like, freak you out or anything. I just wanted to share some info, because, like, you guys are all, like, my fans, and sometimes a YouTuber has got to share some stuff with them. You know, like, spilling the tea, or share some secrets. What's the gossip? Yeah. I hope y'all enjoyed this first episode of It Gets Juicy, and thank you so much for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, turn on post notifications, and share this video with your friends. Also, when you're DMing me about this video on my Instagram story, please let me know if you can relate to these situations. I just figured we might have some stuff in common, you know? Anyway, I love you all to the moon and back, and I'll see you later. Have a great day, y'all. Toodles. Annyeong.